Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. In this week's discussion on the celestial sphere, we are going to talk about circumpolar stars and what it means for a star to be circumpolar. So let's go ahead and start and look at what these circumpolar stars are. Well, a circumpolar star is a star that will never set from a specific location on Earth. So it depends on exactly where you are on Earth, what stars will be circumpolar, but there are some from almost every location on Earth. Now, we know that stars will make circles around the celestial poles. So the pole is the pivot point, and the pole would be located at the very center of all these circles up here in our image that we're looking at. So when we look at stars that are close to the pole, those ones that are near the pole, note how their circles just go around and never intersect the horizon. They don't cross the horizon at all. And that means they are always up, no matter when you look at them. They will always be there in the sky. And those are the stars that we call circumpolar. Now, if you note, as you get a little bit farther down and head farther and farther south in the image, that you get stars that actually are setting. So we'll see stars that set and then rise. But those ones that just skim the ground, that would be the farthest away from the pole that would be a circumpolar star from this location. Now, I said these can vary by location, so let's take a look at that briefly and see what that means. And what we mean here, we have a celestial sphere diagram, and we can see our various points that we look at. We have the zenith straight up overhead. We have the horizon points, the east and the west, and we have the poles. Now the P is the north celestial pole, and we mark that off to the left here. So this would be the north pole in this case, and the P with the prime on it would be the south pole. Now those will always be tilted and inclined by the positioning on the Earth. So the higher you are up on the Earth, the higher these will be in the sky. The lower you are, the lower they will be in the sky. But if you note, there is a section here in green that are stars that no matter where they are in their positionings, in their possible positions, they will always be circumpolar. Those are stars that will always be visible. So the stars in the green are what we always see. The stars over here below the horizon are stars that are never visible from that location. So there are stars that you cannot see from any given location. So stars very far south are not visible from far northerly latitudes. And the same is true for stars that are very far north. They would not be visible from southerly latitudes. So if we look at this, if we can imagine the pole as we went toward the equator, if we imagine this pole getting closer and closer to the equator, the circle around it would get smaller and smaller. And that at the equator, there are no circumpolar stars. Every star rises or sets. If we go the other way and imagining the pole going up to the zenith, this gets larger and larger. And then all of the stars are circumpolar. So all visible stars are above the horizon all the time. And of course, in between, it simply depends on your distance, how far you are from the equator on Earth. The closer you are to the pole, the farther north you are, the more circumpolar stars there will be. And the farther south, the closer to the equator, the fewer circumpolar stars there will be. So let's go ahead and finish this up with our summary and take a look at what we've covered today. And what we looked at was that circumpolar stars are stars that are never seen to set from a specific location. These are the stars that are close to either the north or south celestial pole. And there are a similar set of stars that never rise from any given location. So there are stars that are always visible. And there are stars that are never visible from any given location on Earth, except for the case of perhaps the equator, where every star would be seen to rise and set over the course of a day. So that concludes this discussion on circumpolar stars. We'll be back again next week to discuss another topic on the celestial sphere. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.